Hello everyone, my name is Roland. Welcome by a new video, and today I'm going to talk about false friends. So, what are false friends? Well, false friends are when there is people who pretend to be a friend, but is not really a friend. That is actually what false friends are. Oh wait, that you knew that one already? Oh wait, false friends in languages. There we go. Well, false friends in languages are when the same word has a different meaning. You always need more than one language before this can happen. So let's go into examples then, because I don't think a big explanation is it needed here to what false friends actually are. So, for example, we have the word gross, which means dirty in English, but quo and gross means big in both German and French and German. Another one then, douche. This is actually a bad word in English. So your parents might be not too happy when they see this video, but on the other hand, it's actually a very clean word, because it means shower in French and some more languages, not only French, DBR. Languages in which false friends are common are, for example, Estonian and Finnish. For example, we have the word Vermu or something like that, which means spirit or ghost in Estonian, but the word Vermau means wife in Finnish. So don't get that mixed up whenever you are in Estonia, because you might not sound too romantic. But also in German and Dutch this happens. One of the most funniest ones is this one. For example, zee means lake in German, and zee means sea in the Netherlands. We can see this is actually also a false friend in English itself, because zee, well, it means sea in the Netherlands, but it does not mean sea in German. And another one, that meer means sea in German, well, it means lake in the Netherlands. Dutch also has many false friends with French. For example, bureau means office in French, but it means desk in the Netherlands. Wrong button, my bad. And English also shares false friends with Spanish. For example, the word embarazada means pregnant in Spanish and not embarrassed. So don't get mixed up with the English word embarrassing, because otherwise it might be embarrassing. But not only close languages have false friends. In fact, the languages don't even need to be close to have false friends. And sometimes they don't even look alike. For example, we have a Japanese word here. But if we translate it to writing form, because this is written in Kanto, we can see that you actually write it like pain, but you pronounce it like pine. However, it does not mean pain, but pineapple. So there we go then. I hope this did give a bit of an explanation of what false friends in languages actually are. Not false friends in real life, of course, because otherwise I might get booed again. But there are many, many more false friends than the ones that we discuss in this video. But of course, if you have to take all of these, then the video would take too long, And really big explanation wasn't really needed at this topic. But one more question I do have is, can you think of any false friends? I don't know how well this video is going to get received, but hey, if you think of someone, let me know. So, for now, thank you guys for watching, and I see you at the next video. Good bye.